Hey guys, welcome back to Brilliant Botany, the weekly YouTube series that brings you cool topics in plant science. This week is going to be a little bit different because I'd like to tell you why I became a scientist. This week I attended an event called Poisons and Passions, which was organized by the Story Collider and featured four science communicators telling personal stories about how they discovered science communication, how they became science communicators, or how they learned not to eat the seeds of the tongue oil tree. It was a stunningly personal and touching night. It was so surreal to sit in a dim-lit concert venue surrounded by the world's most prominent science communicators, people who strive to bring science to the public using their passion and their knowledge. I was sitting there drinking a beer, listening to these people tell personal stories about their beginnings. Listening to these stories got me thinking, why did I become a scientist? When did I decide I wanted to become a scientist? As a kid, I wanted to be a teacher, and I suppose I still do in a way. But working in nature and in science makes me feel alive in a way nothing else ever has. I can still remember the exact moment I realized how cool plants were. It was nothing too extraordinary. I was sitting in AP Biology looking at the stamen of a lily under a dissecting microscope. Magnified only a few times, I could see the nubby surface of the anther and the way particles clung to it. I could have sat there for hours dissecting this lily, looking under the microscope and trying to figure out what was so fascinating about it. In that moment, I realized just how cool the natural world can be if you look close enough. I think it was that moment that cemented me as a person who would spend their life learning, however and whenever I could. I am a botanist because nothing excites me more than learning about a new plant species, or debating the attributes of a new technology, or telling someone about the really cool flower I found in my backyard last week. In a world where science is throwing us into the future at an ever-increasing pace, an awareness of science is becoming more and more important. I believe an appreciation of science, technology, and nature can bring us together. Maybe I'm unique in that, because in science, I see the potential for human connection. Science is so much more than just sitting at a lab bench and punching numbers, that it is also so important. Science is also the people who devote their days to repeating that same experiment and somehow conjuring unbelievable enthusiasm about things as obscure as the immune reaction of corn to caterpillar waste. That passion is why I spend my time making posts and videos for you guys, because I believe that by sharing my passion, I can inspire joy in the natural world. It's an amazing world out there if you just look close enough. I get a lot of questions from people asking what they should do if they want to study plants or science or biology, and I like to give one cliche answer to all of these questions. Follow your passion. Find something that makes you feel alive. Learn about the minutiae of orchid pollination if that's what makes you happy. If you love zoology and architecture, there is a place out there for you. I love plant biology, writing, and people, and I am determined to carve out a place in the world where I can follow those passions. I'm a botanist because it makes me happy. I study science because it discovers astounding new things every day. It is truly amazing to listen to a scientist lecture on the research they've devoted their lives to, and in running Brilliant Botany, I hope to communicate some of that passion to you. Thank you so much for listening to my little monologue. I will be back next week with a standard video about the amazing roots that you can find in nature. If you have any questions for me about plants, science, or even about what you should study in college, leave those for me in the comments or ask me over on Tumblr. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. If you live in the New York City area, you should definitely check out the Story Collider. They do monthly events that feature stories by scientists like those I heard this week. The link to that is in the description.